There are doom and gloom stories about crashing fisheries globally. 90% of the big fish have been taken out of the ocean. But there are some reasons for hope in small areas. Places that we protected 30, 40 years ago, small areas, have shown resilience. They have shown more productivity. And so we've been creating more of these places. And inside those places, in the marine reserves here at Anacapa Island in Channel Islands National Park, we now see a kelp forest that recovers after winter storms more quickly than the ones in the surrounding areas that are fished. We see more big California sheephead and rockfish and lobsters and abalone and sea urchins. And we see a better balance of large red urchins to small purple urchins.
Most people are very familiar with lobster.
Now, one of the things we discovered when we remove all of the big animals from an ecosystem is that the system loses its resiliency. It loses its ability to recover from natural stresses like big storms or fires. In the ocean, that means places where we don't fish return to normal much more quickly and are more resistant to the stress of pollution, more resistant to the effects of global change. And so what we're doing now is trying to restore the integrity and stability and beauty and capacity for renewal of these special places. We recognize that you could protect places on the face of the earth, on landscapes and in watersheds, 100 years or more ago. But in the ocean, we've only come to that realization in the last 30 or 40 years. Most ocean conservation is based on the species or based on large ocean current systems. But the idea that you could protect things in place is a new idea. We're lagging maybe 100 years behind place-based conservation on land. The key to stewardship of taking care of places is a little different than trying to care for species, the way we do with migratory birds or with fisheries, but taking care of places is a little different. It requires that the stewards know and understand what's there. They have to have a good feeling for the resources at hand and how they interact with each other and they interact with the environment. So knowing and understanding is the foundation. And next, you have to be able to repair things, to restore things when they're broken. And so you have to know enough about the system to redesign it with the pieces you have left to make it work. Third, you have to be able to protect the resources and mitigate the threats against them. And the fourth thing is connecting people to the places so that people know and understand what's at risk and what they can do about it. So they feel connected and feel part of the process of stewardship. Average people have a hard time connecting with something as big as the ocean. And my advice is think locally. Go down and get to know the ocean in your neighborhood. And in fact, that's one of the advantages. If you want to find nature and you live in a city, a big urban area, if you go to the coast, you can find wild nature right at your doorstep. And national parks are good focal points to do that. There are 75 ocean parks in the system, and they all have programs at the coast that allow people to get involved.